Why the hell do people put 15 amp receptacles on 20 amp circuits? All right, as an electrician, a lot of times you're gonna come across melted receptacles, where a breaker didn't trip, but a receptacle melted at a wall. Usually this is gonna be around Christmas time or, you know, sometime when it's cold and people are plugging a whole bunch of space heaters in and they're overutilizing power at a very specific receptacle. How this happens is most of the time people are putting 15 amp receptacles into brand new houses because code allows us to do that. But they'll still put 20 amp circuits, meaning there's a 20 amp breaker at the panel, there's wire that's number 12 that's rated for 20 amps so it can carry that much current through it. But then you'll have 15 amp receptacles installed everywhere. And it's like, why would we do that? Why would we say that we could run 15 amps worth of current through something, or we could run maybe 18 amps of current through something and the breaker's never gonna trip, but that receptacle over time is not gonna handle that and it's actually gonna heat up and start melting. Why would we allow that? Why would we allow that? Code. That's why. Code. So let's break into the code 210.21. This is the 2020 National Electrical Code. Under 210.21B specifically, it covers receptacles. So B1 says a single receptacle on an individual branch circuit. A single receptacle installed on an individual branch circuit shall have an ampere rating not less than that of the branch circuit. So that means a single receptacle has to be 20 amps if it's on a 20 amp circuit. So there's no problem there. There's no question about that. But then we go down to B3 where it says receptacle ratings, and it says where connected to a branch circuit supplying two or more receptacles or outlets, receptacle ratings shall conform with the values listed in table 210.21B3. So if we look at table 210.21B3, receptacle ratings for various size circuits, on the left-hand side, it's got a whole bunch of circuit ratings and amperes, and on the right side, it's got receptacle ratings. So circuit rating, again, we're talking about the actual rating of that circuit, which is usually talking about the overcurrent device, the breaker. So if we have a, let's say, 20 amp circuit rating, we have a 20 amp breaker, 20 amp wire in the wall, you notice it says the receptacle rating that's allowed is either 15 or 20 amps. Why? Why? Why not just put 20 amps? So if you think about a service, like an electrical service, most of the time we'll have like a 200 amp service on a house. But if you ever take your ammeter and actually clamp onto the conductors, you might have like 20 amps flowing at any time. The likelihood of you ever having 200 amps flowing through that is gonna be so rare. Plus, if you calculate a service, a lot of people think that you're gonna be adding up every single breaker and it's like every breaker adds up to like 400 amps, yet it's only a 200 amp breaker. And it's because most of the time you realize it's gonna be underutilized. We're not using most of the stuff in there, so we don't have to have that big of a service. So we can kind of derate some things a little bit. And that's one way we can think about this, is a lot of times you're not gonna have 20 amps plugged into a single receptacle. You might have 20 amps on the entire circuit because you have things plugged in all over the place. So that's not actually putting any stress on one specific receptacle. That's putting stress on the entire circuit, but it's all spread out. So you're not gonna have a 15 amp receptacle melting because you don't have that one point of contact where you're making all of the metal inside of that plug really, really hot to the point where the plastic starts to melt. So a lot of times they know you're gonna have these things plugged in all over the place. But in specifically where they talk about the loads, the permissible loads that are able to be plugged into a receptacle, that's where it gets a little bit interesting. So if you look at B2, we're still in 210.21, B2, it says total cord and plug connected load. Where connected to a branch circuit supplying two or more receptacles or outlets, a receptacle shall not supply a total cord and plug connected load in excess of the maximum specified in table 210.21B2. So if you look at the load that's being plugged in, that's a little bit different thing than just the receptacle itself. So when you look at that table, you'll see that you have a 15 or 20 amp circuit rating, meaning either 15 or 20, everything in this table on this row is gonna be true. You can have a receptacle rating of 15 amps, meaning you have a 15 amp receptacle. but the maximum load that you're allowed to plug into that receptacle is 12 amps. So if you're only plugging in something that is up to 12 amps, then it's not gonna melt. So that's why it's okay to put a 15 or a 20 amp receptacle on that circuit, because they're saying that you're not allowed to plug any load higher than 12 amps in. So there's just never gonna be a problem. Doesn't matter on a 20 amp circuit if it is 15 or if it is a 20 amp receptacle. But that's the problem. Most people are not electricians. Most people don't know electrical code. Most people are cold in the winter and they just want their toes to be hot. So they go and plug in a whole bunch of crap. So they might plug in two space heaters in the same receptacle, and that might draw like 21 amps. Well, and you're thinking, okay, well, a 20 amp breaker is gonna trip, right? No, not necessarily. So breakers are designed to trip at certain values. So if something happens, the minimum value that is going to trip a breaker is gonna be 20 amps if it's a 20 amp breaker. But we know that breakers have two different methods of tripping. There's a thermal trip, which is a slow buildup of heat over time. And for the thermal trip to even ever engage that breaker, it has to hit 130% of its value. So that's 24 amps on a 20 amp breaker. So then if we, that's just for heat. So 21 amps being drawn on a 15 amp receptacle, the metal inside of there is only really rated for 15 amps worth of current going through it. So if you have 21 amps over a long period of time, it's gonna heat that metal up so much on the inside of the receptacle that it's gonna start melting the plastic around it. And that breaker's never gonna trip. It's never gonna sense that there's actually a problem because we're not hitting that 130% value. And then breakers also, we've talked about this in other videos, breakers have the 200% trip as well, and that's not a thermal trip, that's a magnetic trip, and that's usually if there's a ground fault or a short circuit. There's like a wham, like a huge impact. So it has to trip at least 200%. So that's how you know, like a breaker might not actually trip even though you've got too much stuff plugged in. But it's because we're banking on the fact that most people most of the time are not gonna be plugging a whole crazy huge load into a receptacle. Most cords are rated for a certain thing. So if you have a toaster that you plug in, it might have like a 15 amp cord because they know that toaster is not gonna draw more than, you know, 12 amps or whatever. So they just put a 15 amp cord on it. So when you're plugging that one device in, there's not gonna be a problem, but there's not a load that comes with a 15 amp cord on it that you buy from a store that actually draws 23 amps. That just doesn't happen. They make these things, there's NEMA ratings, manufacturers have to follow things. But the problem becomes when people plug multiple loads in and they get over the amount that it was designed for. So if you didn't know out there, you're really only supposed to put on a 15 amp receptacle, whether it's a 15 or a 20 amp breaker, you're still only supposed to put a 12 amp load into any one receptacle, any one like duplex receptacle. So the other part that kind of mentions this, it's at least worth noting because they kind of worded it in a little bit different way, is in 210.23A, it says 15 and 20 ampere branch circuits. A 15 or 20 ampere branch circuit shall be permitted to supply lighting units or other utilization equipment or a combination of both and shall comply with 210.23A1 and 2. So A1 says cord and plug connected equipment not fastened in place. So not actually an appliance that's like stuck in place, something you just, that's like portable, like vacuum cleaner, toaster, or something like that. The rating of any one cord and plug connected utilization equipment not fastened in place so shall not exceed 80% of the branch circuit ampere rating. A lot of people confuse this to think, oh, you can't load circuits up more than 80% of the breaker rating. That's not what this is saying. It's saying any device that you plug in shouldn't be more than 80% of that specific circuit's rating, that branch circuit's rating. So it's the same thing if we look at how they said in table 210.21B2 on a 15 or 20 amp circuit that with a 15 amp receptacle, they're saying basically we don't want you to plug anything more than 12 amps in. Or if you look at a 20 amp circuit with a 20 amp receptacle, you don't want to put anything more than 16 amps. That's a single load plugged into this thing, and 16 amps is 80% of a 20 amp circuit. So it's saying the same thing. 80% is the same thing as whatever is in this table down here for 16. So it's not saying that you can't, that you're like supposed to leave extra room. A lot of people think that too. Like you're supposed to leave 20%. So like if more things get plugged in, that's not what they're saying. It's specifically a thing that you take and plug in shouldn't exceed a certain amount. But again, we're electricians. We might know that Mr. and Mrs. Homeowner, Mr. and Mrs. Homeowner are gonna plug stuff in wherever people are gonna plug stuff in. So my rule of thumb is generally with commercial, I'll always put 20 amp devices in on 20 amp circuits. I don't ever do anything like this. Residential, I might do 15. The other thing, reason why people do 15 is because it saves a lot of money. 20 amp receptacles versus 15 amp receptacles, they cost more. There's more metal, they're a little bit more stout, so they cost more, plus they're just marketed as a bigger number, so they cost more, really, is probably more to do with it than anything. But Home Depot, places like that, they sell in bulk. They sell 15 amp receptacles, so you're even gonna get cheaper pricing just because you get sales. They sell things in 15 amp all the time. So more people put 15 amp receptacles in homes, especially if you're putting like 300 or like 800, if you're doing some big custom home, that's a massive difference between, 15 amp to 20 amp receptacles. So that's kind of why people do it. But code does allow us to do it. You just got to understand the why behind doing it. But you do need to know that people, especially if you're in like really cold places, they're gonna be plugging space heaters in. So maybe that's something you take into account and give them dedicated circuits with a single receptacle so they can only plug one load into it. Or maybe if they wanted two space heaters in an area, give them two single receptacles on two dedicated circuits that are 20 amp with 20 amp space heater, single receptacles. Then you're just not gonna have a problem. And then the rest of everything else, you could use 15 amp. But you don't even have to do that because of code. But always remember, code is the minimums. It's just minimum safety, minimum, protection for people and equipment and things like that. So you can kind of do whatever you want as long as you're staying within code. But it is good design, good practice to probably just put 20 amp receptacles everywhere, because then nobody's gonna have a problem. You've kind of overbuilt the circuits, and that's best case scenario. But it all comes down to the fedia, right? Like the dollar. So that's why. Hope you got something out of that. So that is it. If you want to know a little bit more about how breakers work, I actually have a video right here. It goes over the whole 130%, 200% thing, and I actually crack open some breakers and we talk about how a breaker actually works. And if you want to know about specific breakers, like we talk about arc fault, ground fault, and dual function breakers, click this video right here. So I love you crazy people. Thank you so much for your attention. Make sure you sub, super helps me out. Like the video if you like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.